everybody. Welcome, welcome, and thank you for joining us on Medic Monday in the Spokane Valley Fire Department. I'm going to be your host, R.W. Pegau, and without further ado, let us begin. Today we're going to do a quick lecture and a quick understanding on what is the difference between cardiac arrest and a heart attack. Oftentimes these are synonymous terms or terms that are used ever so similarly. I'm going to put the little Ann off to the side here for a moment. But truthfully, they are not the same thing. This is a complex couple of topics, and I'm sure anybody who's a cardiologist is going to be rolling over irritated at how I describe it, but I'm going to give you a very street, realistic understanding of what heart attack and cardiac arrest are. Okay? Heart attack is a big process of which the heart degrades, whether it's through lack of blood flow or an impediment or anything like that, or electrical challenge that says, hey, I'm going to degrade to such a level that, though it won't be instant, at some point I will get to where the heart can't function and cardiac arrest occurs. Let me tell you what cardiac arrest and heart attack are not. They're not what you see in Hollywood on TV, that is, somebody walks, clutches their chest, and collapses. Okay, that's not heart attack. Heart attack was happening for hours prior to that. And that's a good thing. And let me tell you why. Because you have the opportunity to intervene. If you can accurately figure out from your own friends, family, and loved ones what some of these signs and symptoms of heart attack are, you have the opportunity to help guide their treatment, whether it's by calling 911 and allowing us to get ALS treatment on board right away for them, or by taking them to a cardiac hospital earlier than later, you have a great chance of guiding their treatment to the best possible outcome. One of the advantages that you have, if you are having chest pain, jaw pain, if you're a lady and you're, say, 30s or 40s or above, if you're having stomach upset with mid-scapulary shoulder pain, these should be indicators you should take seriously to at least get checked out. And here's what I mean by checked out. Get an EKG done and get your blood drawn. How many of us can relate to this? You take your car, it's got a squeak or something wrong with it, you take it to the mechanic, and it's been squeaking for on and off for 2 or 3 days. You take in the mechanic, finally, right? And of course, they can't find anything. There's nothing squeaking. And so they send you home with the quote unquote clean bill of health, and you're no better off, right? Okay, don't let that happen. If you're having the squeak, if somebody's having the chest pain, if they're having the symptoms, get EMS to come right away. Because one of the things I will do is I will draw your blood right away. I will get an EKG strip right away of exactly what I see in the field. And what that will be is my way of helping advocate for you that, yeah, that squeak was real. Here's the evidence of it. You have a very specific set of enzymes that are released when your cardiac tissue is under duress, and it doesn't release otherwise. So it's a great indicator that that squeak was real, even if when you get into the hospital, the cardiologist doesn't necessarily see it. It proves to them that the event happened. So I would really encourage you, I'd highly advocate for you, if you're having any chest pain and anything like that, or your loved ones are, get EMS, call 911, get us there as early as possible so we can advocate for you and try to grasp some of those symptoms. Don't be one of the people that is the Hollywood, the time you tell somebody you're having chest pain is when you clutch your chest and collapse over to die. Because truthfully, that person had hours of symptoms before you. Okay, let's break it down just simplistically though, what is happening in the body. All right, so let's say that the heart attack is happening because you're having a massive constriction of vascularity, okay? You've got plaque buildup, right? Like, unfortunately, many of us do. Cholesterol seems to be some level of a commonality with that issue, but a lot of us deal with this. Okay, well, at some point, instead of it being an open chamber like this, it's now ground down to like that. Okay, well, depending on how exerting of an activity you are doing, your body might need a whole lot more blood flow through the opening than that. And so you get the symptoms of chest pain, shortness of breath, fatigue, tightness, something like that. Sometimes saying chest pain is the wrong way to say it. I know a lot of times when I go to somebody's house, they don't like the word pain, but it's chest discomfort, it's chest abnormality, it's a tightness. It's dull, it's something like that. So I guess maybe I shouldn't say pain all the time, because oftentimes you have people who don't have pain, but it's very discomforting, okay? That is a sign from your body saying, hey, I can't get the blood flow in that I wanted before. And with that lack of blood flow is a lack of oxygen. That's going to be one of the first things you have, is you're going to get a decreased oxygen or an ischemia that attacks the heart, okay? That often is accompanied with a sensation, though. All right, that'll last. That'll last for hours and hours, potentially even days. It's a profound amount of time that your body tries to do this. It tries to reroute blood flow. It tries to reroute electricity as needed to make sure that everything fires the way it's supposed to. The body's gonna try to compensate so hard that when it gives out, it's a precipitous decline and it's over. By the time we are in cardiac arrest, the body's already tried everything that it could think of to prevent us from getting to that point. And again, what I take out of that is a positive, is that you have a lot of time if you can start recognizing the signs and symptoms of heart attack and not just reacting to cardiac arrest, which is gonna require you to do CPR. Because at that point, there's no labs that I really need to draw that help you. I mean, you need your life. Your life is in the balance at this point, right? So we wanna do everything we can to understand that heart attack is not the same thing as when somebody collapses over dead. Heart attack is the totality of the symptoms and the challenges that occur to the heart that may or may not result in cardiac arrest. Let me hit you with something else. Some people have heart attacks and they don't go to the hospital and they don't die from it at all. But there's evidence of that heart attack on their EKG, because part of what happened is some tissue did die in the heart. And in order for it to beat the way it needs to beat to sustain their life, it had to electrically change itself. And that electrical change will show up on the EKG, okay? So there's some evidence, even if you've had one in the past, that yeah, you did have one. To reiterate, I would super encourage that anybody that is having chest pain, shortness of breath, chest pain, any tightness, dullness, any sensation you wanna use, I would encourage you to call 911, especially if you're having an associated symptom of radiation, which means that, like, you're having chest pain here and you're feeling it into an arm, into a hand, into your jaw, into a neck. Ladies, again, if you're not having the classic chest pain, but you're having stomach distress with upper back pain, that's a huge kind of outside the box indicator that you also might be having something. So I'd encourage you all to take chest pain seriously. Understand that you have time. Chest pain is almost a good thing to have, because it allows us to get a chance to react. And please remember, don't let it go by unannounced. Call 911, get EMS to show up, and let us capture that squeak so when we take you to the cardiologist, we can advocate for you to the best of our abilities. All right, stay safe.